Alfred Onen, the Avogera Village Chairperson, Local Council 1, has noted that oil discovery in the region has attracted several businesses in the areas which need electricity supply, but to their dismay, up to now, the government has failed to connect several villages with power.
It has taken long, because ever since, since I was born, to town like in Blisa, Huima, as well, can have access to an assistant.
Sometimes I see naked poles, and I saw some poles over there going to Para, that side of the game park, that side. I even don't know where they stop because I don't see them.
Edivanis Mboneka says that due to lack of electricity in the area, communities are failing to engage in business which requires electricity.
If at all you try to look around within Ngwedo sub-county, it is very hard to get a house with a metallic door. They all have these timber doors, just because wooden doors, just because they have no access to those metallic doors. And once you come across that metallic door, it is too expensive, just because people who are making them are very few, just because of lack of electricity.
Yoram Alinde, the head teacher at Avogera Primary School, says that lack of electricity has not only affected communities but also the education of children in the area.
Without electricity, teachers at night don't plan, because as a primary teacher, as our code of conduct is stating that we should plan, that is scheming, lesson plan. So they have not been lesson planning and they have not been skilled.
He added that the school is also facing a challenge of poor performance and high dropout rates as a result of lack of electricity.
Parents have been doing their own thing. They have not been even encouraging their children to come to school. There has also been high dropouts because a child has lack of guidance and counseling from home. So generally, more especially, it's very worse. With the girl child.
Musa Pemundu, a resident, says that they have on several occasions petitioned the government to connect their area, but in vain.
Even the other time, Umeme people came and surveyed this area, and what they told us, they are going to bring for us electricity power here at school, the health center.
We have been putting our requisition to the district official, like the Shaman C5, and even to Total, since we have a Avogera Health Center here, where most of the people are always access health facility here, and we are also near Central Processing Facility in this old project. So they promised to bring us electricity.
He adds that the area has able people who afford electricity, but wondered why they were left out during the implementation of the rural electrification program.
Majority has money for sure that they can use to pay for Umeme, only that it is not there. And they doesn't know how important it is because it is not within.
As a sign of relief, D-Light Solar Company has donated 2 solar panels and lighting systems to make learning and navigation easier for pupils at Avogera Primary School.
We have installed solar here at Avogera Primary School. One of the discussions we're having with the team and the headmaster and management is to make sure that after installing, let them use this solar very well, let them not tamper with it, let them make sure that the way we have left it, that's how it should be. It carries a 3-year warranty period.
Meanwhile, Evelyn Nyakato, the district councillor representing Ngwedo sub-county, has urged residents to remain calm as plans are underway to connect the sub-county on the national grid. Power lines are going to pass through Kisomero to the health center. We also ask the line to go to Ngwedo Seed School from Bogishindo and Buduku 1. According to the information from the Energy Ministry, the power coverage for the entire country currently stands at 27%. Story compiled by Ambrose Niwagabakatoto for the news.